This is one of the most fascinating places on Earth. Located in South America and accounting for half of the tropic's primary forests, the Amazon rainforest spans across 9 countries. It's responsible for producing 20% of the world's oxygen. It's easy to be captivated by its size and unique ecosystem. However, this rainforest is known for being a little extra, and you're about to see why. If it's not the vampire fish, it's the huge anacondas. If the spiders don't kill you, the poison dart frog will. You ready? Here are 15 of the deadliest monsters of the Amazon rainforest.
Good evening. I'm standing here under a roost of about 40 vampires.
Number 15. Giant otters. The giant otter, living in South America and the largest of the otters in its total length, is the cousin of the sea otter and river otter in North America, Europe, and Africa. Known throughout much of their range as river wolf, they're amongst South America's top carnivores. When a caiman attacks the otter cubs, the whole family comes together to defend them. When a jaguar encroach on their space, the otters fight back. Giant otters are very territorial. They prefer habitats with non-floodable banks that have vegetation cover and where there's easy access to hunting places and relatively shallow waters. They're seen within the Amazon, Orinoco, and La Plata river systems and are found in slow-moving streams and rivers, lakes, swamps, and marshes, as well as flooded forests during the rainy season. This species is diurnal and lives together in family groups numbering 5 to 8 individuals. A family consists of a mated pair and their offspring of several generations. If intruders invade the family's territory, the parents will defend it and their family members. Despite maintaining separate territories, giant otters are highly social mammals. Social activities include hunting, grooming, resting, and communicating. Now, let's get ready for today's open discussion. You've heard of the Loch Ness Monster, right? It's a creature in Scottish folklore that's said to inhabit a lake in the Scottish Highlands. It's often described as large, long-necked, and with one or more humps protruding from the water. In Canadian folklore, the Ogopogo is a lake monster said to inhabit Okanagan Lake in British Columbia. Could the Amazon have such a creature of one of its many lakes? The largest lake in the Amazon basin is Lake Hunan of central Peru, located at about 15,000 feet above sea level. There are hundreds of smaller lakes as well, so you know there's gotta be some undiscovered monsters in them, like this thing. And what's with those glowing white eyes? Let us know what you think this creature is in the comments below. What would you do if you came face to face with a monster like this? Use the hashtag #OpenDiscussion. You want to know a little secret? If you smash the like button, subscribe, and click the notification bell, you'll have superpowers for the rest of your life. So what are you waiting for? Time to fly. Number 14, tree boa. This boa is a non-venomous boa species found in South America. This species exhibits an immense variety of colors and patterns, anywhere from black, brown, or gray to any shade of red, orange, yellow, or many colors in between. Some are totally patternless, while others may be speckled, banded, you name it. These snakes live in tropical moist forest and flooded forest of the Amazon. They're solitary arboreal creatures. They spend the majority of their lives in the trees. These snakes are active both during the day and at night. When hunting at night, they use their heat pits to sense the prey, but when Amazon tree boas hunt during the day, they use their vision. These snakes are known to be very aggressive. They have very long, needle-like teeth, which makes their bite quite painful. However, these snakes tend to give some warning of being inclined to bite and will usually give fairly gentle bites, which can still draw blood, unless they're given reason to give a full strike. These snakes are quite slim and don't have the mass of some of their other constrictor cousins. So, prospective owners should be advised that the snake is an undomesticated animal capable of causing injury. Number 13. Vampire bat. Bats are the only mammals that can fly. But vampire bats have an even more interesting distinction. They're the only known mammals that survive solely on blood. They tend to live in colonies of thousands in almost completely dark places, such as caves, old wells, hollow trees, and buildings. The basic social structure of roosting bats is made of harems. These are composed of females and their offspring, and a few adult males known as resident males, and a separate group of males known as non-resident males. Female vampire bats form associations with one another that can last for many years, and they're believed to be the only species of bats in the world to adopt another young bat if something happens to the bat's mother. Like the legendary monster from which they get their name, these small mammals drink the blood of other animals for survival, sleeping cows, pigs, horses, and birds. Though uncommon, vampire bats occasionally bite humans for blood. Rather than sucking blood, vampire bats make a small cut with their teeth and then lap up the flowing blood with their tongues. These bats are so light and agile that they're sometimes able to drink blood from an animal for more than 30 minutes without waking it up. Each night, vampire bats drink about half of their body weight in blood. Number 12. Piranha. After sharks, these creatures are one of the world's most misunderstood fish. Piranhas are found in freshwater rivers, ponds, and streams throughout northern South America, and they have a reputation for being ferocious. In Hollywood, they're often depicted as ravenous pack hunters who won't hesitate to eat their way through people, but in reality, piranhas usually try to avoid humans out in the wild. Many different fish are called piranha, but the number of species is a matter of debate. Based on current data, there are between 40 and 60 different species of piranha in 12 different scientific families. The most commonly known species is the red-bellied piranha. Most piranha don't get any bigger than 2 feet long. They're omnivorous foragers and feed on insects, worms, crustaceans, and fish. Piranha often travel in shoals as a predatory defense, but rarely exhibit group hunting behavior. Acoustic communication is common, along with aggressive behaviors. Through media influence, the piranha has developed a reputation as a ferocious predator, though this is not actually the case. They're a popular aquarium fish, believe it or not. Number 11. Black caiman. This alligator has its own ecological niche that enables coexistence without too much competition. They reach up to 17 feet long, with females being slightly smaller than males and being about 10 feet long. Typically, they weigh around 800 pounds, but can get as big as 1,000 pounds. As the largest predator in its habitat, it may also be a keystone species, playing an important role in maintaining the structure of the ecosystem. The black caiman is the largest member of the alligator family and the largest predator in the Amazon River basin, averaging 13 to 16 feet in length. The species gets its name from its dark, black skin coloration, which provides camouflage during nocturnal hunts and is thought to help absorb more heat. They have thick, scaled skin, and their eyes and noses are located on the tops of their heads. This enables them to see and breathe while the rest of their bodies are underwater. While black caiman aren't the most aggressive members of the crocodile, caiman, and alligator family, you shouldn't try to touch one. These are wild animals, and they can be very territorial, especially if they have a nest and eggs nearby. It's a dangerous species to humans, and attacks have occurred in the past. Number 10. Arapaima. One of the world's largest freshwater fish species, these giants can grow to 15 feet long and weigh up to 440 pounds. The arapaima is an air-breathing fish that swims in the rainforest rivers of South America's Amazon basin and nearby lakes and swamps. As air breathers, arapaimas can only stay underwater for 10 to 20 minutes. They tend to stay near the water surface before coming up to breathe, using a modified swim bladder that opens into the fish's mouth and acts as a lung. The noisy, distinctive gulp makes it sound like a cough and can be heard from far away. The predatory fish isn't a picky eater either. It primarily feasts on other fish, but it also eats fruit, insects, birds, and even mammals. They can't survive in cold water, so they're not known to venture near North America regularly. But parts of Southeast Florida may now be warm enough to host them, which could pose a threat to the region's existing wildlife. And since an arapaima can lay thousands of eggs per year, it wouldn't take long for it to become a major invasive species. Though this species was once abundant in the Amazon basin, it's now on the brink of extinction in some areas. However, researchers are hopeful that more stringent conservation efforts will bring arapaima populations back. Number 9. Brazilian wandering spider. This spider's scientific name literally means murderous in Greek, and it's no wonder why. Its bite can be deadly. The Guinness Book of World Records has named the Brazilian wandering spider the world's most venomous spider. They look mean too. Because of the toxicity of their bite and their alarming looking posture, these spiders have a reputation for being aggressive. And we can see why. These behaviors are actually defense mechanisms. When threatened, it will raise their first two pairs of legs, and their threatened stance serves as a warning, indicating to predators that this poisonous spider is ready to attack. However, their bites are a means of self-defense and only done if they're provoked intentionally or by accident. These spiders are big too, with legs spanning around 6 inches and bodies reaching up to 2 inches. But don't worry, they spend most of their day hiding under logs or in crevices and come out to hunt at night in search of insects, other spiders, and sometimes small amphibians, reptiles, and mice. If you're bitten by any species of the wandering spider, you should seek emergency treatment. Regardless of how the bite appears to be initially, it's very important as the venom could be life-threatening. Number 8. Poison dart frog. Golden poison frogs are tiny terrestrial diurnal frogs that live primarily on the forest floor, but some species live high in the forest canopy and may never come down. All are native to warm Central and South American rainforests, like the Amazon near streams or ponds. Poison dart frogs are carnivores and survive on a diet of small insects, including fruit flies, termites, ants, young crickets, and some smaller species of beetles. They're excellent opportunistic hunters, relying on their long, sticky tongues to flash out and catch fast-moving prey in the blink of an eye. But no matter what you do, never touch them. The frog's poison is found in their skin, making them too toxic to touch. The golden poison frog is considered one of the most toxic animals on Earth. A single specimen measuring 2 inches has enough venom to kill 10 grown men. The indigenous people of Colombia have used its powerful venom for centuries to tip their blowgun darts when hunting, hence the species name. Still, despite its poisonous ways, golden poison frogs are known as the jewels of the rainforest. But don't be fooled, their sparkling golden colors, however, are not for beauty, but are really a warning. Number 7. Electric eel. If you're fond of movies and nature documentaries, there are chances that you've seen an electric eel in action. You might have wondered whether or not it's true, and yeah, it is. This amazing creature can produce electricity. How do electric eels create electricity? Are they dangerous to humans? These creatures use 3 electric organs to produce shocks, and these electrical discharges help them catch prey and ward off predators. There are around 6,000 electricity-generating cells stacked up together in the body of an electric eel. They also produce weaker discharges that aid navigation and communication. While the voltage is high, researchers suggest that due to the low amperage of the shocks, they're unlikely to be lethal to humans. Also, an electric eel produces electricity in pulses rather than continuous bursts, and following a large electrical event, the animal needs to recharge. Understandable, right? And did you know this eel isn't an eel at all? The animal is a type of knife fish and can discharge an electric shock reaching as high as 860 volts, the most powerful of any animal known to science. But electric eels cannot live in the deep sea. Unlike other fish, they cannot breathe underwater, so they need to come to the surface quite often for air. Number 6. Bullet ant. Native to the western rainforests of South America, the bullet ant is the largest ant in the world, reaching over an inch in length. It lives in colonies of several hundred ants, usually situated at the base of rainforest trees, rarely venturing on the forest floor. Worker ants forage for small arthropods such as spiders, insects, centipedes, and nectar, one of the bullet ants' staple food. The workers are fiercely territorial, demonstrating aggressive behavior toward rival bullet ants. As for their bite, in Venezuela, it's called the 24-hour ant because the pain of a sting can last a full day. Once bitten, the pain lasts anywhere between 5 and 24 hours with symptoms described as waves of excruciating pain, temporary paralysis, and shaking in the poisoned area. The venom contains a type of paralyzing neurotoxic peptide, and the sting causes a local sting reaction. In other words, the pain is only located in the area of the bite and the venom doesn't spread to the heart, brain, or other parts of the body. But there will be nothing in your world apart from pain for at least 3 to 4 hours. Despite its ferocious traits, the ant is normally quite docile towards humans and other larger animals, reserving the use of its mighty sting solely for defensive purposes. Number 5. Jaguar. It was much easier to find these big cats a century ago when their territory extended as far north as New Mexico and Arizona in the US and as far south as Argentina. Due to threats like deforestation and habitat degradation, they've lost almost 50% of their range. Today, the majority of jaguar populations are condensed to the Amazon. Jaguars and leopards are often mistaken because they're both tawny-colored, spotted, big cats. Most obvious difference between the two is in the spots. Scientists believe that these spots help break up their outlines in the dense forest or grass, giving them more opportunities to hide from their prey. These majestic cats have a stocky, heavy build with robust canines and a massive head, allowing them a more powerful bite than any other large cat relative to its size. Studies comparing the bite forces of 9 different cat species revealed that while a jaguar's bite force is only 3/4 as strong as a tiger's bite force, jaguars have the stronger bites since they're considerably smaller. A jaguar's jaw can bite straight through the skull of its prey and can even pierce the thick skin of a caiman. But unlike most cats, they don't mind getting wet. Number 4. Payara. This is one of the craziest fish that you'll ever find in the Amazon. Not only does it have a mysterious reputation due to a lack of research on the species, but it also has an unforgettable appearance that includes 2 gigantic fangs. That's why the payara is famously known as the vampire fish. These fangs can be 4 to 6 inches long. In fact, the 2 main lower teeth are so long that the upper jaw has holes for them to fit into. Its nicknames are saber-toothed tigerfish and water wolf. It literally eats piranhas for a snack. Payara are fast and aggressive feeders. These fish usually swallow their prey whole but will sometimes chop them into smaller, bite-sized pieces. So polite. They get large too. This fish can reach up to 4 feet in length and weigh up to 40 pounds. The record holder for the biggest payara in the world was a specimen caught in Venezuela in 1996. It measured 3.5 feet and weighed 39.4 pounds. As for the rest of their build, they're streamlined for power and speed. They have fan-shaped caudal fins that help them swim in choppy currents and rapids, and bony faces which hide large gills. It likes clear, fast-moving water with lots of currents. You'll often find it churning rivers and the bottoms of waterfalls. Number 3. Bull sharks. It may surprise you to learn that there are sharks lurking in the murky waters of the Amazon River. The Amazon region is home to what scientists consider to be the most dangerous shark in the world, the mighty bull shark. Bull sharks are hefty, heavily built animals, spanning lengths of around 7 feet and with an average weight of 500 pounds. They also have the strongest bite force of any shark, up to 1,300 pounds. It's just amazing the level of adaptation being able to survive in the ocean and in the Amazon River system too. In 1937, 2 fishermen captured a 5-foot bull shark more than 1,000 miles up the Mississippi River. As far north as this species is known to travel up that river, given their high tolerance for fresh water, it's no wonder that bull sharks do well in river systems. One specimen was found swimming in the Amazon River about 2,485 miles away from the ocean. The bull shark is named after the fierce land animal and acquired this label for a couple of reasons. First, it has a stocky shape and a short, blunt nose. Second, bull sharks are notorious for their aggressive, unpredictable behavior and known to headbutt their prey in a bullish fashion as a prelude to attacking. All types of shark-on-human attacks are ultra rare. You're more likely to get struck by lightning. Number 2. Anaconda. A member of the boa family, the Amazon's green anaconda, pound for pound, the largest snake in the world, can grow to more than 35 feet and weigh more than 800 pounds. Like other boas, anacondas lack venom with which to neutralize their prey. Instead, they lie in wait for an unsuspecting mammal, fish, or amphibian to wander within reach. Then they lunge, catch the prey in their jaws, and wind their incredibly muscular bodies around the animal until it suffocates or dies from being crushed. Powerful jaws attached by super stretchy ligaments allow them to swallow their prey, no matter the size. Four parallel lines of backwards-pointing teeth help the serpents grip their prey and swallow it whole. On a diet of wild pigs, deer, birds, turtles, capybara, caimans, and even jaguars, they can go weeks or months without food after a big meal. If you want to find an anaconda, they live in swamps, marshes, and slow-moving streams. They're a little slower on land, but stealthy and sleek in the waters. In addition to their breath-holding ability, anacondas, like crocodiles, have eyes and nostrils on the tops of their heads so that they poke above a river's surface while the rest of the snake is still underwater. No wonder the stealthy semi-aquatic predators are occasionally called water boas. Number 1. Giant centipede. The Amazonian giant centipede is one of the largest centipedes in the world, with a length of up to 12 inches long. Yeah, a foot-long centipede. This species is found in various places in the Amazon River system. It's a carnivore that feeds on any other animal it can overpower, including other invertebrates such as large insects, spiders, millipedes, scorpions, and even tarantulas, but also small lizards, frogs, snakes, sparrow-sized birds, mice, and bats. Large individuals have been known to employ unique strategies to catch bats, in which they climb cave ceilings and hold or manipulate their heavier prey with only a few legs attached to the ceiling. Centipedes tend to hunt during the night, so for this reason, they rarely come into contact with humans. Bites reportedly cause severe pain, local swelling, and nausea, although death from bites are rare. In most cases, healthy individuals survive. At least one human death has been attributed to the venom. In 2014, a 4-year-old died after being bitten by a giant centipede that was hidden inside an open soda can. The Amazonian giant centipede is not only very venomous, but is extremely bad-tempered. It's best to know before you go if you're ever visiting the Amazon. It's a fantastic place for sure, but as you can see, there are some pretty deadly monsters waiting there. Since you're here, like and subscribe, share with your friends, and stick around for more great videos.